So let's start with types of silhouettes. What is silhouette actually? Silhouette is the outer shape of anything. It may be a garment, it may be an animal, it may be a furniture, it may be a home or something. Just like, suppose I'm making a picture of a chair. Right, so this is a picture of a chair, but what is the silhouette of this chair is this, the outer shape. We don't have to consider the inner lines. This is the silhouette of this chair, right? So like this, every garment has its own silhouette. So that we are explaining in today's video, right? So generally we have 15 kind of silhouettes, general silhouettes. Apart from that, it may be a various variations, it may be the various classifications, but basic silhouettes are of 15 types in to the best of my knowledge. The very first is that I am explaining is straight. The straight silhouette does mean the garment which is straight from the armhole or in the outlook, like this. Right? Some of the people also called it eye line. Fine, it is straight or eye line. This you can see the silhouette, basic silhouette is straight. Second is sheath, S as name suggests, it is just like the sheath of a sword. You have seen the cover of sword. It is very much fitted to the, it is little bit like this. It is not straight, it is little bit inside. This is called the sheath. Third one is V line. V line is much narrower than the sheath. It generally has a slit at this portion. It may have a slit just to maintain this, right? Number four is A line. A line is little bit this outward. Like this. When A line is little bit more broader, it is called trapezoid. This is much broader than A line. It is called trapezoid. Next is tent. Tent is much broader than trapezoid. A line, like you can see the connection, straight, sheath, little bit narrower, right? Broad, broader, broadest. Now, it will have a more flare than as compared to trapezoid. This is tent. Right. Number 7 is bell. Bell is something which is actually have the shape of bell. Waistline. Bell gowns, and you can see these kind of garments, or in sometime in anarkali suits and all, you can feel this bell wala portion. Next is hourglass. This is that gives the look of hourglass. Hourglass, you must have seen a glass which in ancient times it shows time. This is hourglass. You can see the shape. Number 9 is blossom. Or it is also called blouson. Blouson impact is actually just like a flower is blossom on a I hope you have understood that there is a dress which is tied at the, which is loose at the top but tight at the bottom. It is tied at the waist with a belt, and it is just like you tuck in your shirt and pant or skirt and keep it little bit out. So this gives the impact of blouson. 10th one is balloon. It gives the impact of balloon, just like this, and just like you wear sometime the harem pant or something, so it has that impact. It is like this. Eleventh one is teddy. This impact you can see generally in the jumpsuit of that kind of dresses. Like I'm creating one for you. Twelfth one is T-line. These garments are just like your t-shirts and all. You can see this impact. Next one is square. Square is a silhouette that you can see generally in garments like kaftans. Right. Number 14 is asymmetrical. Asymmetrical silhouette is generally, it may be asymmetrical at many places. It may be symmetrical at neck. But because we are talking about the outer shape of the garment, so it should be asymmetrical at outer shape. Right? And number 15 is mermaid. Mermaid style of dresses are, if you are following me in sketching, we have created one mermaid gown very recently. It is till knees, it would be fitted, and below that, it would be sometime it may have a joint here, or sometime may not. Right? So, this is mermaid style. Apart from that, people even do call the empire line, which we have learnt in waist line and all, the princess line. Princess line comes from here like this, but this is not the outlook of the garment. So this is style line, but this is not the silhouette of any dress. So always remember, silhouette does mean the outer shape of the garment, whether it is a skirt, top or something, but the outer shape also is always considered as the silhouette. So this is all about the silhouettes. And apart from that, now we'll be in the next lessons, we'll be coming up with the some garments like skirts, pantaloons, tops, jackets, and then accessories. So till then, you wait for this, and very soon we'll be meeting with a new topic. Thank you.